Hello everyone, it's Jin Teacher coming to you from Reading Town. It's good to see you. Let's take a look at today's article. The title of the article is The Lightest and Smallest Satellite. So lightest means not heavy, right? It's very light, the most light, and the smallest satellite. And it's going to tell us what the satellite is. And that is the person behind the lightest and smallest satellite. And that is what the actual satellite looks like. So as you can tell in the picture, satellite is something that flies around the Earth. So let's see what the article has to tell us today. It says, a satellite is an object that orbits a larger object, such as the Earth, Sun, or other massive body. So satellite is something, and orbit means go around. So if we have the Earth, a satellite goes around, right? Something like the Earth, which is a larger object. So it's a small object that goes around a larger object, right? Such as the planets, right? So we have other moons that are like satellites of some of our planets in our solar system. And it says here, they can be divided into two types. So there are two kinds of satellites, natural satellites and man-made satellites. So man-made means we made it, humans have made it. And natural satellites meaning no one made it, it just happened in nature. So a lot of the moons or the small planets, they have a lot of natural satellites, things that are circling around it. But here it says an 18-year-old boy who lives in India named Rifath Shahrukh has developed the lightest and smallest satellite in the world. So this is an 18-year-old boy named Rifath Shahrukh, and he is from the country of India, and he was able to make the lightest and the smallest satellite in the world. And it says here, he created the satellite in order to participate in a contest. Cubes in Space, jointly organized by the US Space Agency, NASA, and a global education company, iDoodle Learning Incorporated. So why did he make this small satellite? It's because he wanted to participate or join a contest, right? And this contest was held together or jointly by NASA and another education company called iDoodle Learning Incorporated. So these two large companies or groups came together to make a contest, and that's why this boy named Rifath Shahrukh from India joined and made this satellite. He called it Kalamsat, named after India's nuclear scientist and former president APJ Abdul Kalam. So the name that he gave was named after a very famous scientist, nuclear scientist, and the former president of India. So here we learn about where it's from, why he made it, and let's finish out the rest of our article. The satellite is made of reinforced carbon fiber polymer and weighs a mere 64 grams. So it's talking about what it's made of, and it's not made of metal or other heavy things, but carbon fiber is a very, very, very light material, and it's strong enough so that it won't break easily. And reinforced means it's stronger. So it's not just regular carbon fiber, but it's reinforced, meaning it's a stronger type. And polymer means a mixture of many different materials. So we know that it's very light, and it's weighs about 64 grams, very, very, very light. He said, we did a lot of research on different cube satellites all over the world and found ours was the lightest. So they looked around, they studied, they found out what are the other cube satellites, and they realized and they learned that theirs is the lightest. It will be launched in space on June 21st by NASA. So they're going to send it to space, they're going to launch it to space, and it's coming up very soon this month in June 21st. The main role of the satellite will be to demonstrate the performance of 3D printed carbon fiber. So here we're talking about a lot of technology these days, and a lot of technology is going to be printed by three-dimensional printing. And they're trying to see how strong is that as a satellite, how strong that could be, and they're going to send it out into orbit to test it out. So very interesting article about a very intelligent, smart boy and the satellite that he created and will send to space. Very interesting. So if you look at the comprehension questions today, there in the picture, we can see a rocket being launched into space. And maybe that's how they're going to send the small satellite to orbit the Earth. And it says here, what are two types of satellites? There's two kinds. So we said satellites are a small object that goes around or orbits a larger object, and there's two types. And one of them is what the boy made, and that is the man-made satellite. But also in nature, there are natural satellites like planets or large rocks that are going around a larger object like a planet. What is the satellite made of? So what was the material? We said it's not made of something very heavy. It's not made of steel or metal, but it's made of reinforced, strong carbon fiber polymer. And we said polymer is a mixture of several different kinds of material. So this is the type of material that's used, carbon fiber. What is the main role of the satellite? So what is its purpose? What is its purpose? What's it going to do in space? We talked about that during the article, can you remember? And they want to show that 3D, three-dimensional printed carbon fiber is very strong. They want to show that by sending this small satellite into outer space. So it's not really going to serve a function as to help us with our cell phones or internet or communication, but it's just mainly going to show that it's very strong. So very interesting test that they're doing. Let's take a look at the last part of our comprehension questions today and fill in the blank with the correct word. It says a satellite is an object that's something, a larger object, such as the Earth, Sun, or other massive body. So we said that a satellite goes around. So what was the word for going around? We learned that today, and it's orbits. So just like the moon orbits the Earth, and the Earth orbits the Sun, the satellite orbits around our planet. Let's look at the second question. It says, an 18-year-old boy who lives in India named Rifath Shahrukh has blank the lightest and the smallest satellite in the world. So what has he done? Has he drawn it? Did he think of it? What did he do? And we said that he was the person behind it. So he developed, or he made it even better. Right, so he made and created this, the lightest and smallest satellite in the world. Quite an achievement. And it says here, the last question, he called it Kalamsat, something India's nuclear scientist and former president APJ Abdul Kalam. So why did he name this? We know that it's because of a person that he respected, India's nuclear scientist, right, as well as a former president. So the reason why he named this the Kalamsat is because of this person. So that's why we say he named it after, right? So that means when you have somebody or something that you really like, and then you want to show that you like it, so you give it a similar name, that's when we say named after. So today we saw a very interesting article, we read it together, about a boy in India, only 18 years old, not very old, and he had the idea to make this very light satellite. And they're going to send it out into orbit very soon, and we're eagerly excited and waiting to hear the results. So carbon fiber, as well as 3D printing, a lot of technological advances, and even young people all around the world are starting to use it and get to know it. Maybe you will get to learn about and use some of the things that we learned about in today's article. Well, I hope you enjoyed today's article and learned a lot. I will see you again next time. Goodbye, everyone.